Hello everyone, and welcome back to another Monster Hunter Rise video. Today we're going to be breaking down what the wire bug is, how it works, and how to effectively add this new tool to your hunting tactics. Wire bugs are an integral part of your hunter's toolkit and offer a plethora of mobility options as well as some new attacks. Now it's important to remember that wire bug moves rely on wire bug charges. These charges cost wire bugs. But don't fret, these bugs will recover over time. The ZL button is what we like to call the wire bug button. Pressing ZL in conjunction with other buttons will allow you access to a wide variety of moves. Some of these will allow you to reposition, outmaneuver, and hunt your prey in diverse and unique methods. We're going to take a few moments to break these moves down so that you're fully prepared for the hunts ahead. Now, before we go any further, it's important to remember that these moves are contextual and will change depending on whether your weapon is sheathed or drawn. Let's start with those available to you with your weapon sheathed. Pressing ZL and A on the ground will send you hurtling forward in the direction that your hunter is facing. This ability allows for fast repositioning either towards or away from the threats your hunter may be facing. Pressing ZL and X on the ground will send you in a diagonally upwards trajectory. This is an incredibly useful ability that will help you get aerial advantage over your targets, or quickly reposition to avoid incoming grounded attacks. Holding ZL and then pressing ZR will fire a Y-bug in the direction of your reticule. This will propel you in that direction with greater precision than any of the other methods. In the air, pressing ZL and ZR again will operate exactly as before. However, pressing A or X whilst airborne will operate somewhat differently. Pressing ZL and X will keep you airborne and allow you to travel in the direction your hunter is facing. This is incredibly useful for maintaining mobility while staying airborne. Whereas ZL and A will send you diagonally towards the ground. This is perfect for those wanting access to grounded attacks and moves at a moment's notice. If you're having trouble remembering all of these, think of them like this. ZL and X will either get you airborne and keep you there, and that using ZL and A will keep you grounded or get you there. Pressing A whilst airborne will cause you to halt momentum and utilize a wire bug to hang in the air. From here you can evade in a chosen direction by tilting the left stick and pressing B. This is an excellent maneuver for repositioning, recovering stamina, and taking evasive action. When knocked off your feet by monster attacks, you can use the wireful technique to dust yourself off and get back into the fray. Press ZL and B whilst knocked over to reposition and save yourself from a monster's onslaught of attacks. Performing a wire dash when facing a wall will allow a hunter to perform a wall run. From there, you can traverse sideways or upwards, but at the cost of your stamina. Whilst wall running, your hunter will have access to other moves such as wall jumps or attacks.
This is for my fellow hunter!
With your weapon readied, you'll have access to unique wirebug assisted moves, known as Silk Bind. Silk Bind attacks can be triggered by pressing ZL and X or A, depending on your weapon's moveset. Ranged weapons can trigger these moves by holding R and pressing X or A whilst their weapon is drawn. We hope you've enjoyed this brief overview of the basics of using the Wirebow. We hope you'll take this knowledge and develop it even further when you get your hands on Monster Hunter Rise, which arrives on Nintendo Switch March 26, 2021.